We are here at AWS reInvent, and the future of cloud and Gen AI and the overlap is a key focus. With me is an expert on both matters, Filippo Scognamiglio. He is a managing director and partner at BCG. He is also global head of cloud advisory. Filippo, thanks in advance for the time.
Thanks for having me.
So this year has been a breakout year. Gen AI, super hot topic. What effects are you seeing on the cloud industry?
Well, first and foremost, tremendous amounts of investment. Like Microsoft clearly has a leading partnership with OpenAI, and they've been making great inroads and building capabilities on their cloud platform Azure. Amazon and Google have been racing to catch up and potentially even leapfrog what Microsoft have been doing and pouring tremendous amounts of investment in this space.
So at BCG, you have introduced a standardized pricing index for the cloud industry. What are you seeing?
Well, lots of surprises. In fact, it's our first attempt at creating the equivalent of a Big Mac index, but for cloud resources specifically to make them comparable in a space where historically prices really were not that comparable considering their complexity. In looking at these comparisons, we found actually quite a lot of surprises. I think the biggest one is that cloud is not more affordable in emerging economies. Matter of fact, it is more expensive in emerging economies. The cheapest location to run cloud workloads actually happens to be the US. Which is not what we expected when we initiated this research.
Yeah, that sounds surprising. So when you think of the year ahead and for those who are looking to utilize Gen AI, I have to ask you an age-old tech question. Is it better to build or is it better to buy?
When it comes to web-scale large language models, buy is definitely the choice right now. As trying to replicate what some of these companies have done in your own local environment is prohibitively expensive. I do believe that in the future we will find more specialized models that can operate at a smaller scale for specific purposes and use cases. And with that class of models, I think we'll find an opportunity to build in addition to relying on the quote bought models from the cloud service providers themselves.
Filippo, thank you very much. Filippo Scognamiglio joining us there.